With the release of the new Revit 2026, we have a big update when it comes to walls with the introduction of the wall layer priority parameter. In this video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how it works and how to set it up. Let's go. Now, quickly before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, that's definitely the best place to be with over 140 hours of content. Recently, we became an Autodesk authorized training center, so check it out. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and more importantly, this is Revit 2026. And here we have a couple of walls. So even though they look similar, they are two different walls. So we have this one, which is called test wall constant. And then we have this one, which is test wall variable. So this one is where we're going to be making changes and then see what that looks like compared to the original one. Now, when it comes to walls adjoining, you can see that here, if we select it, now make sure that you're on the fine level of detail. Here you'll notice that each layer connects to the layer on the other side. So basically when this is selected, it kind of creates that zigzag line with the selected wall and the one that isn't selected. Now with the wall layer priority parameter, we can control how this connects and we can actually change the connection here. So let me show you how that works. If you select a wall and go into edit type, here you'll notice that if we go under structure and click on edit, that now we have this new column, which wasn't available in previous versions of Revit. And here we can set the priority of these layers. So I just went from 1 for the structure, then for the substrate 2, for the thermal air layer 3, and then here we have 4. And for materials, I've just created colored materials just so we can kind of differentiate those a little bit better. Okay, so now let's say that we want to make a change. So now let's say I want my thermal air layer and my substrate layer to connect to the finish layer of the other wall. Well, I would just go here to priority and then set all of these to 4 and then hit OK, apply, OK. And now what happens is you can see all of these layers, so these three layers connect to the fourth priority layer, which is this one here. So it's just going to connect all the way there. So it's going to go kind of past here. So this is what happens. Now I can select this again and let's make another change. So go into edit type, go into edit here. And now let's say I change this to something like 2. Now let's do that on all of these, just like that. So change the priority, hit apply. Okay. And now as you can see, this these three layers, this one is the with the level 2 priority. So all three of these connect to that and stop at that layer. So that's why this layer is now connecting and going all the way through to the kind of end of this side. Now it's important to note that this all works basically defined by that layer priority, but it's also defined by the wall join. So this can be a little bit confusing because a wall join is a separate kind of modification tool. It's located here on the modify tab. Under geometry, we have the wall joins tool. If I select that and then select this join, see how it recognizes the join. You click to select, and now you can kind of toggle which of these walls has the priority. But again, it will still go up to the layer 3 in this case, I think. Yeah. So yeah, you can change it a little bit, but still the priority is determined by that priority parameter. And this is just kind of toggling the connection type that you might want to use. So we have that, and now this is set to butt, but we also have meter, which is just going to give you a diagonal join. Now, when you do this, when you set it to meter, pretty much the layer priority kind of falls off into the water just because it's, well, it's no longer really applicable in this situation. But if it's set to butt or square off, it's going to be active and you will be able to see that. Also, one thing that's kind of interesting, you can go here and you can make it a clean join, which is now, or you can go with don't clean join. So it's going to do something that looks like this. In most cases, you don't want this, but in case you do, yeah, this is how you set it up. Clean join is this, and usually I set it by view settings, which is usually going to be a clean join just like that. So there we go. That's how the wall layer priority parameter works in Revit, and be sure to use it on your next project in order to customize your walls and make them look exactly how you want them to look in all of the floor plan views. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.